Have you ever wondered the rule for when to use C or K? Let's learn the cat and kite rule. When we hear K in the beginning position, we have to figure out the vowel that follows and comes after it. Let's draw a picture to help us remember. Grab a sheet of paper and a writing utensil and split the paper in half. On one side, draw a big C, and on the other, a big K. Let's start with the C for cat rule. Looking at the vowel that follows it, C likes vowels A, O, and U. Now you can finish your whiskers and your ears to create your adorable little cat. This shows up in the words like cat, cob, and cup. Okay, now let's look at K, the kite rule. First, create the outline of your kite using the outside of your K. You're going to create a diamond. Now let's look at how you spell kite. K-I-T-E. We have already used K. Now, let's use that T. We're going to make a big lowercase t in the middle of our kite. Now what vowels are left over in the word kite? You are right, I and E. K loves I and E. It also likes Y, but that will come up later. For now, it can be the tail of your kite. Just save it in your memory bank. Some examples of these words are kid and Ken. Great job! Let's go practice!